don't think a lot of conservatives or Republicans know Joe Biden that well. He was the head of the Judiciary Committee when Clarence Thomas was confirmed for the Supreme Court. Of all of the Democrats that are running, Joe Biden is center of left more than anyone else.
So are you saying, Tommy, that you are getting comfortable with voting for Joe Biden?
Absolutely. I am absolutely. He's a decent man.
You'd
He's an
rather vote.
honorable
You'd
statesman.
rather.
He
I
has a
really
life
think that
story.
we're talking about Joe Biden right now. Joe Biden is the same one who said he didn't want his kids growing up in a racial jungle. We're talking about Joe Biden who said you can't go to a 7-Eleven or a Dunkin' Donuts unless you have a slight Indian accent. You're talking about Joe Biden who has a history of aligning himself with people like Robert Byrd, who was an actual former Grand Wizard of the KKK. So if you call him a decent man, that's actually a slap in the face to any minority thinking person.
What about there are good people on both sides at a KKK rally in Charlottesville? Why doesn't that one bother you as much?
When President Trump said that there were good people on both sides, what he meant by that is there are obviously going to be extremists on both sides of the aisle. Nothing is more evidenced of that than what we've seen recently with far left people and far right people. I think my support for him is strengthened when he's willing to call out people like the rioters and protesters out with BLM right now. What we're seeing right now is an opportunity that a lot of people are taking to exercise their displeasure with the results of the 2016 presidential election, and they did not let that go.
And these continue to be so interesting because they give voice to things that we often see in the numbers. And one of the outstanding questions I've had for months, if not years, is what's the real-time impact of this Project Lincoln type thing? These never Trumpers, people like Jim Mattis, who is, you know, not in Project Lincoln, when they come out and say something, does it have any impact on Trump voters? And all these people voted for Donald Trump. But you saw Monica and Tommy and Daniel indicate that when people like Mattis or others come forward, it does have an impact over time. That jumped out to me.
I'm interested in that as well. And the other thing that I hear is that we've always heard the great passion from really dedicated Trump supporters, like you heard Bianca there in the middle and Damani. And now you're starting to hear, I think for the first time, that same level of passion from the people who voted for him in 2016 but now regret it. So all of the people in that lower row could match Bianca's passion, and that was just new for us.